All right, Shalom.
Shalom.
First and foremost, want to give all praises to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Kakwadash, double honors to the elders and apostles of the great millstone, and peace and blessings to the whole collective of Israel. And there's going to be a quick, almost home. You know, the title of this one's going to be Hide Me.
Mm-hmm.
All right, because as we can see, things boiling, all right, going into the prophecy is getting ready to pop off. We want to be safe, okay? That's ultimately going into the conversation of the righteous, the elect, is that we want to be preserved from these times to come. Okay, so by our faith and by our works, like it says in the book of Second Exodus, we're going to be saved by. Okay, and that's what the time we're coming into. There's going to be great destruction and a great deliverance. All right, so brother can go ahead and get started.
Yeah, Khan. This is Psalm 64 and verse 2, and it reads, "Hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked, from the insurrection of the workers of iniquity."
Yep. So the secret counsel of the wicked, all right, because these devils are plotting something very sinister upon this planet Earth. Okay, it ultimately is going into that chip, okay, the RFID microchip, which is the mark of the beast. This devil's going to implement it on the earth and deceive a lot of you people taking it. Okay, that's going to be a destruction. All right, but the elect, they're not going to be deceived. But just because we're not going to be deceived does not mean we're going to have a scot-free lollygag, pretty much jury to the kingdom.
Yeah.
You know, it says through much tribulation. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're going to feel the heat that our temptation is going to try the whole world.
Yeah.
You know, so we're asking the Lord to hide us from that council, because the council is what? To destroy you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and the Americans, and going to the elect. This is a time of our persecution. Our ministry is wrapping up, you know, going through all those apostles on down, okay, and it's time to endure, okay? But it says from the insurrection, okay, because you read in Exodus as well, it says what? They're going to be a great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord. Okay, you got martial law troops. All right, this whole place is getting surrounded, okay, because this man, the devil that runs this world, is getting ready to come down with great wrath, because he knows that I have but a short time.
Right. And also, too, he knows that a lot of people are getting ready to pretty much, you know, say that they're not with the New World Order, man. You know, a lot of people are getting ready to pretty much be like, man, you know, to hell with this man, you know, system. And that's why he's going to have to pretty much lock Jake up, you know, lock majority of you people up, because we know he already know you're not down with it, man.
Mm-hmm.
So he's like Elder Pastor said, he's going to have a hard time pushing this New World Order, man.
Yeah.
Psalms 91 and 1, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty."
Yep. So the secret place of the Most High is what? This truth. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what we've been doing, laboring, you know, day in and day out, okay, week in and week out, going to our apostle and elders on down. Our apostle and elders on down is for a reason, okay?
Yeah.
You know, we're trying to be safe in these times to come. That's why going into, you know, with Isaiah 4 and 1, okay, because the man that the Lord is talking about was us being hopeful elect, we play those men, we're going to be stable, okay? Because why? We have the fear, okay? We have the wisdom, we have the knowledge, okay? You know, so before the evil days came, we was thinking about the Lord, okay? Praying and doing things to get his attention to what? For us to be delivered out of here, you know, because this is the time. This is what it's been all about. Okay, what's the message? All is getting ready to break loose, and if the Yahweh Bashar size on 4, you're going to be destroyed, right?
That's right. Isaiah 26 and verse 20, "Come, my people, enter thou into thy chambers,
mm-hmm.
and shut thy doors about thee. Hide thyself, as it were, for a little moment, until the indignation be overpassed."
Yep. So guess what? The elect are going to have a covering. Okay, they have the angels around them, okay, protecting them, because they fear the name of Yahweh Bashar Yahushai. So the Lord's gonna make a way for us to eat, make a way for us to be safe. And ultimately going to those secret chambers, that's talking about the chariots, okay? The so-called UFOs, those men that you laughed at, made fun of, called their life madness, you're gonna be amazed at the strangeness of their salvation. Okay, getting beamed up, okay, literally getting beamed up, getting abducted, okay, into ships and being changed, okay? You know, this is gonna really happen for the Lord's elect.
Yeah.
Right.
And that's why 2 Exodus 15, to back you up, it says, "Let not the incredulity of them trouble thee, because all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness." A lot of our people don't believe that, man.
Mm-hmm.
Like the brother, you know, going into, man, the Lord is getting ready to hide us, all right, but in the chariots. But Jake don't know what the chariots is, man. Jake don't know that that's his salvation, man. You know what I mean? So by our fear and our faith, all right, we're going to be saved, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right. It says, Psalms 27 and 5. It says, "For in the time of trouble he shall hide me,
mm-hmm.
in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock."
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
No.
Go ahead. That rock is who? Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
Okay.
That's
our rock is Yahweh Shai. That's that solid foundation.
Spirit.
Okay. Our faith in Yahweh Bashar Yahushai. Okay. Because going into what? 2 Exodus 8 chapter. It says this land shall be, if I'm not mistaken, it says this land shall be barren of faith.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it 8th chapter?
Yeah, I think it's 8th chapter.
He probably can check.
I got you.
But, you know, this land's going to be full of no faith. Okay. And that's why Yahushua said, "When I come, shall I find faith?"
Yeah.
Okay. Because there's going to be no faith. okay? And that's going to that substance that you people thought was a joke. You wanted to cover that after gold, silver, okay? Yeah. You know, instead of faith, yeah. Okay? Building yourself up in this time to come.
Yeah, this is a 5-1. I got you.
Oh, Kantua.
Connie, it's the second Ezra. Okay. Second Ezra is 5-1. It says, nevertheless, as coming the tokens, behold, the days shall come that they which dwell upon the earth shall be taken in a great number. Mm-hmm. And what is that great number? Two-thirds. That's why in Jeremiah 30:7, it says, the last that day is great, for there is none like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble. But what? He shall be saved out of it, man. Mm-hmm. Going into that hiding place, all right, the Lord Yahweh Shai is going to set us upon that rock in a time of trouble, man. Mm-hmm. And that's why in Isaiah the 32nd chapter says, a man shall be as a hiding place from the storm.
Yeah.
And as a covert from the tempest, man. And water in a dry land, you know. And what is that? That's that wisdom, knowledge, understanding of how we're going to be able to be stable, mm-hmm. and unmovable in the faith, abounding in the work of the Lord in this time that we're coming into, mm-hmm. man. Because like the brother Mayam always speak on, the work don't stop. All right, when we can't do videos, nah, man, we still gotta conduct ourselves in a holy manner,
yeah.
And still walk in wisdom all the way to the end, man. Second Ezra 5:1, I'll start from the top for you. Nevertheless, as coming the tokens, behold, the days shall come that they which dwell upon the earth shall be taken in a great number, mm-hmm. and the way of truth shall be hidden.
Yep, so the light is going to be taken off the streets, man, going into that famine of the word. And that's how you know it's going to get very, very dark. All right, well, that's what happens. You get turn off the lights, it's pitch black, okay? Yep. And that light dwells within his men. Okay, that says, greater is he that's in you than he that is in the world. Okay, we have the wisdom of Yahweh Shai inside of us, okay? Ultimately going into our minds. All right, so when we're taken off the corner, we're persecuted, we're enduring our thing, you know, according to the, you know, the prophecy that we're going to catch up. But nonetheless, for you people outside of here, all right, outside of the faith, you're going to be in big trouble. It says, you know, the land's going to be barren of faith. We're getting to that point, you know, because again, you know, like you think about stocks and bonds, all right, you know, it's a point in time where faith is going to hit, okay? If people watching Bitcoin might hit $100,000 or whatever else, but guess what? Faith is going to what? Equate to the everlasting kingdom, all right? Being faithful over a few, going to be rulers over many, you know?
I got that word barren too in the etymology for you.
Kanye.
It says, in the land shall be barren of faith.
Mm-hmm.
It's that word barren in the etymology from the 1200s. It says, incapable of producing its kind.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so it's going to be incapable for you, Jakes, to actually produce the fruits of faith because you never had it to begin with. That's why the scriptures say in the book of Second Ezra, as for faith, it shall flourish.
Yeah.
And the truth that have been so long without fruit shall be declared. Speaking of who? The elect, man. You know?
And it's going to be a difference because these men have been chosen.
Mm.
Okay? You didn't make yourself believe the Lord chose you. He said, I loved you first. So that's why, again, it's going to make that man so precious because he literally been chosen by Yahweh Shemshai, the maker of all existence. Right?
Con, that's it on that. I got one more for you.
Come
on. This is the book of Psalms, chapter 31. All right, Psalms 31 and verse 20, and it reads, thou shalt hide them in the secret of thy presence from the pride of men.
Yeah.
Thou shalt keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues.
Mm-hmm.
You got it.
Yep, because Esau, you know, the proud man that he is, he thinks he can ultimately upset prophecy. Mm-hmm. Okay, he's going to even fight against the Lord. All right, so, you know, we have to be hid from this man because this man is going to even destroy his own self. All right, so what can you do with a man that's, you know, suicidal, okay, you stay away from that dude, okay? Right. Because he's nothing but a ticking time bomb. This devil is going to be pretty much the boogeyman and scare everybody to not believing, okay? You already see it now with the vaccines, people lining up to get vaccines, sow some guns, sow some badges, and people fold, okay? But going into the elect, all right, the elect are going to stand strong, okay? They're not going to bow that knee. Mm-hmm. And the Lord Yahweh is going to be with them the whole time,
that's right.
Okay?
That's right.
But we got any closing points?
Yeah, no, I just wanted to back you up. You said the elect is not going to fold nor bow the knee. Well, that's why in 2 Ezra 2, it says those that stood so stiffly.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and in Romans 11 chapter, okay, it says those that will not bow the knee to the image of all, the Lord have them reserved, man. Mm-hmm. So the elect is on reservation as far as getting the golden ticket to get ducked off into that hidden place that we're talking about, ultimately being the chariots of Yahweh Shai, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and Lord's will we be those men. You know, gold tried through the fire, an acceptable man in the furnace of adversity, man.
Yeah.
You got it right.
Yeah, because this thing ain't over with, man. Going into this, we're coming to the beginning. Mm-hmm. This world's getting ready to end, okay, but we're coming to true life, okay?
Right.
True existence, all right? You know, under Yahweh Shemshai and his elect, okay? And that's what we're waiting for. We don't care about this place being destroyed. So be it, you know, even if we have to lose our own lives, okay? You don't die, okay?
You're gaining it, actually.
You gained your life, okay? It's a great reward for obedience, all right? And that's what we're doing, being obedience in the faith. We're just men, okay? The Lord's going to turn his men up. We're going to get powers. Hey, man, it's going to be a showdown, okay? And we can't wait, you know, but Lord's will, we, of course, will be part of them. We keep strong to the end, because that's the point. Endure to the end, the saints shall be saved. All right, keep a humble mindset, you know, keep your head down and ultimately look up, because our salvation draw nice. So with that, Lord's will is be edifying. As always, we give our praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Bashem, Kakadash. The bond is again to the elders and apostles of great millstone. Peace and blessed hope for Israel. Shalom.